Now we discuss about chemical classification of anti-cancer agent. In my previous video, you have seen how to remember trick for remembrance of anti-cancer agents. Here we are going to classify broadly into four categories. One is alkylating agent, the second is anti-metabolite, third is an antibiotic, fourth is a plant products. So we will finally fifth one is a hormone, which affect the hormones. So cut. Now we discuss about chemical classification of anti-cancer agents. In my previous video, you have seen the trick to remember the anti-cancer agents. So here in chemical classification, just we take little important class of drugs only. We will not take all class of drugs. So that's why it is mainly five categories of drugs or five class of drugs you will get. One is alkylating agent, second is antimetabolites, third is antibiotics, fourth is plant products, and fifth is hormone regulation products. Okay, now in the alkylating agents, they're again subclassified as a nitrogen mustard, as well as the alkyl sulfonate, ethylenamine. So if you see the example for nitrogen mustard, mechloroethamine means, so what is that means? 1,2,1,2, so 2,2-dichloro, the IUPAC name will be there, 2,2-dichloro N-methyl ethyl amine. What is the IUPAC name? 2,2-dichloro N-methyl 2 ethyl groups are there, diethyl N amine. Okay, diethyl amine. So this is IUPAC name, very simple structure, and it contains mainly it contains what the living groups, chlorine it contains, amine group it contains, methyl group it contains, and ethyl groups. So that is the structure of mechloroethamine. Me means methyl, chlor means chlorine, eth means ethyl, amine means amine. In the name itself indicates me means methyl, chlor means 2 chlorine groups, dichloro. Then eth means diethyl groups. Amine means amine, nitrogen, tertiary amine. So name itself we can remember the structure. The first structure is mechloroethamine. Second one is cyclophosphamide. This is also same. Instead of methyl group here on nitrogen, methyl group, you are having a cyclic ring containing phosphoxide group. What it contains? It contains phosphoxide groups. So phosphate and the NH group is present in the ring. So instead of methyl group, you are having the ring containing the phosphate and amide group. So that's why it is called as a phosphamide. Phosphamide means phosphate and amine group is present in the ring. Cyclophosphamide means cyclic phosphamide. Phosphamide. Rest of structure remains same as the mechloroethamine. So instead of methyl group, you are having cyclophosphamide. So this is in a structure of the cyclophosphamide. Second example, that is. Third example is chlorambucil. Chlorambucil also remains same. Instead of methyl group here, it is having a ring structure containing butanoic acid. Okay, aromatic ring structure containing butanoic acid. So methyl group is replaced by methyl group of mechloroethamine is replaced by benzene with butanoic acid, CH2-3COOH. So this is a structure of chlorambucil. So chlorambucil, so you have the chlorambucil. Bucil means butyl, so like butanoic acid. So butanoic acid, chlorambucil. So that is in a first category in case of alkylating agent. In the second class is alkyl sulfonate. In the same alkylating agent, you have busulfine. So busulfine means here you can see that sulfoxide groups are there. Butyl 1, 2, 3, 4. So busulfonate. Sulfonate means ester type of things. Sulfonate 8, 8, 8. So there is an 8 here. So 8. So this is called as a butyl group. So name itself busulfane. Sulfane means sulfoxide group with methyl sulfoxide. SO3 CH3 is present. SO3 CH3. So sulfoxide with methyl group is present. That's why the name is busulfane. Bu means butyl and sulfoxide with the methyl group on either side. So that is the structure of this. And the third one is ethylene amine. Ethylene amine, it comes under alkylating agents last class. Example, thiotepa, thiotepa, thiotepa. It contains ethylene amine. It contains phosphate with thio group, sulfur group, and 3-thiotepa. 3 means it is tri. Okay, 3 ring system containing nitrogen means azuridine. The ring name is called as azuridine. Three-membered ring containing nitrogen, heterocyclic means azuridine. 3 azuridine rings are there. And a phosphate with the sulfoxide group is present. Phosphate with sulfoxide group is present. So that is called as an example is thiotepa. It contains a azuridine ring. Okay. So this is the one class of agents. Okay. So the other class of agents are anti-metabolites. What are these anti-metabolites? When we go for the mechanism of action, we will study what is the meaning of antimetabolite. But now we see just the structure. The first one is purine antagonist. Example is mercaptopurine. Mercapto means it is in a mercapto group, SH group is called as in a mercapto. So mercapto group is present. So mercaptopurine, what is the purine? Purine chemically known as 6-membered ring containing nitrogen at first and third. It is called as pyrimidine. Pyrimidine, it is called as pyrimidine. This is called as imidazole. So chemically we know that what we know means purine is nothing but combination of pyrimidine fused with imidazole is called as a purine. 6-mercaptopurine, example is 6 mercaptopurine at a 6th position. This is a 6th position. If you number it at 6th position, there is a mercapto. So in the name itself indicate mercapto SH group. Name itself indicates that 6th position there is a mercapto. Purine means pyrimidine fused with imidazole ring. That is one example for purine antagonist. Next is thiogonine. This is also purine antagonist. It contains purine. It also contains SH group, but there is a extra is a NH2 group, amino group. Difference between the structure of 6-mercaptopurine and thiogonine, one amino group is present at this particular position. Is this clear? So now second category is pyrimidine antagonist. Pyrimidine means 6-membered ring containing 2 nitrogen at first and third position are called as a pyrimidine. So 5-fluorouracil, suppose this is first number, the number it like this 3, 4, 5, 6. 5-fluorouracil. Uracil is also a base of pyrimidine bases. If you know the DNA structure, RNA structures, you'll come to know that bases, nitrogenous bases. Okay, adenine, guanine, cytosine. Adenine, guanine, cytosine, thiamine. This all contains purine and pyrimidine bases. So 5-fluorouracil. So fluorine group is at 5th position. That's why it is uracil. Now next, last in this category, last one is folic acid antagonist. Folic acid antagonist, the structure name is methotrexate contains a basic nucleus, 6-membered ring containing nitrogen first and third, is called as pyrimidine fused with pyrazine. Pyrimidine fused with pyrazine and two amino group, they are called as pteridine. What nucleus? Pteridine. 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 So pteridine. Many times in GPAD examination, this question has been asked. What is the basic nucleus present in the methotrexate? It mainly contains pteridine. What is pteridine chemically means? Pyrimidine. Pyrimidine means 6-membered ring containing nitrogen at first and third position are called as pyrimidine fused with pyrazine. 6-membered ring containing nitrogen at first and fourth position. So pyrazine and pyrimidine fused together are called as pteridine. Many times they have asked para-amino benzoic acid like side chain, and there is an amino acid containing butanoic acid. Butane, it is mainly contains 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5. So pentanoic acid. So pentane 1,5 dioic acid is present. And here para amino benzoic acid. So side linkage, it is linked with methylene group CH2. So pteridine with para amino benzoic acid type of structure, followed by amino acid structure is there. So those amino acid structure, as well as the para amino benzoic acid and methotrexate pteridine, all together are called as a folic acid antagonist. Example is methotrexate. These are two categories. Next we go for the third and fourth categories
of anti-cancer agent is antibiotics. So what are these antibiotics? Example, daunorubicin, doxorubicin, bleomycin, dactinomycin. This all comes under a class of antibiotics. Now I have taken only two examples, because dactinomycin as well as the bleomycin, the structure is very huge and you cannot draw it. So, and also it is a natural product. Sometimes they are obtained from the microorganism naturally, or semi-synthetically they have been done. So whenever you get naturally, the structure will be very complex. So here daunorubicin, doxorubicin are the two examples that I have taken. Here you are having tricyclic ring system like anthraquinone. What is the nucleus present in the daunorubicin or doxorubicin? Means the four ring with two double bond, they are called as anthraquinone nucleus. So this anthraquinone nucleus is having, and there is a COCH2R. Only R will be varied in case of daunorubicin and doxorubicin, R as well as R1. So I have given you, and here hydroxyl group is there, COCH2R. So now if you take the daunorubicin, R is H, R1 is methoxy group. Doxorubicin, R is OH, this R is OH, and this is methoxy. So only R and R1 will be varied, but basic nucleus is anthraquinone. So many times this question also has been asked in the GPAD examination. Next is, fourth one is plant products. So plant products are also a very important class of anti-cancer agent. So they are mainly two examples, vincristin and vinblastin. So this is also from natural, obtained from Catharanthus roscius, belonging to the family of Epocynaceae family. So these vinca alkaloids are very effective in the anti-cancer. The basic nucleus present in this vinca alkaloid is benzene fused with pyrrole. 5-membered ring containing nitrogen is called as a pyrrole. Benzene fused with pyrrole, it is called as indole. what it is? Indole. So indole is a basic nucleus present in this structure, and indole 6-membered ring containing a nitrogen saturated, they are called as piperidine. This is piperidine. So complex structure is there, but you have to know the basic structure. So there is only one difference between vincristine and vinblastine. In vincristine, at this nitrogen benzene fused with, here there is no double bond. You have to see here there is a double bond, but in this ring, double ring systems, if you see here one side one ring system and here one side one ring system, here benzene pyrrolidine is there because saturated. This is pyrrol, unsaturated. This is saturated, that's why pyrrolidine, benzene fused with pyrrolidine. But this is indole, this is saturated indole. Okay, so if you see that the difference in this nitrogen, you can find aldehyde COH in case of vincristine, but in case of vinblastine, that nitrogen becomes, on that nitrogen only methyl group is present. So methyl group, if it is a methyl group, then it is called as a vinblastine. Very minor differences you can find with the structure between vincristine and vinblastine. They are the vinca alkaloids obtained from Catharanthus roscius, belonging to the family of Apocynaceae. Okay, so this is fourth class of anti-cancer agent. Fifth class is miscellaneous. Example, cisplatin. It containing platinum, PT, as well as chlorine groups, alpha orientation, beta orientation, ammonia groups. Okay, so they are majorly in the alpha orientations as well as the beta orientations. So when it is an alpha orientation, you can write, but when it is a beta orientation, you have to keep the positive charge. Okay, so this platinum with two chlorine, two ammonia group is called as a cisplatin. And the other example is mitotane. This is called as mitotane. Mitotane, it contains dibenzene with a 3 chlorine group, 4 chlorine groups. That is called as a mitotane. Yes. So that is a major class of cytotoxic agents. These all are 5. But the next class is hormonal, which varies the hormone. So hormonal levels, hormone is very very important in case of breast cancer. So in the best breast cancer, this hormonal therapy has been given. So in this case, estrogen, progesterone, they are the steroidal nucleus. You already studied, you just go through with the structures once again. So it is a very simple steroidal nucleus, estrogen, progesterone, and also the trans and cis type of tamoxifen structures all will come under a class of hormones. Okay, so hormonal, that affect the hormones, is in a second category. First category is cytotoxic drug. Under cytotoxic drugs, we are having 5 major classes. I told you in the first class is alkylating agents, second class is antibiotics. Okay, sorry, second class is anti-metabolite, third class is antibiotics, fourth is plant products, fifth is miscellaneous. The second way, broad classification, which affect the hormones, example, estrogen, progesterone. So they are steroidal hormones. Okay, this is all about the classification of anti-cancer agent, chemical classification. Now, chemical classification.